इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग स्कूल वडोदरा. दिस इज एफिलिएटेड टू गुजरात टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी. आई शैल बी स्पीकिंग ऑन पॉलीमर जेल इलेक्ट्रोलाइट फॉर एनर्जी स्टोरेज एप्लीकेशंस. दिस इज हाउ आई हैव ऑर्गेनाइज माई प्रेजेंटेशन. We all know fossil fuels has captured more than 80% of the energy needs. These fuels are costly, pollution causing, and are exhaustible. Therefore, people need to discover and search for the better kind of secondary battery systems which have low cost, natural abundant, and good electrical properties. For realizing electrochemical system, a good kind of electrolytes are required. Using the gel based electrolytes, people are working on lithium ion batteries. In year 2019, Nobel Prize has been awarded for the development of lithium ion batteries. This prize has been shared by three scientists. And the lithium ion batteries are not ultimate one. They also suffer some drawbacks. For example, the fire incidents which you have might have gone across the newspapers, and apart from that, dendrites is a critical issue with these batteries. So what happens is, in the case of the lithium anodes, the needle kind of structure starts growing, they passes through the separator and then touches with the cathode. Therefore, the short circuiting happens and the operation of battery is being hampered. These lithium-ion batteries incorporate polymer-based electrolytes. These kind of electrolytes are having membranes, having transport properties quite comparable with that of the liquid electrolytes. The specific advantage of using such electrolytes is the high ionic conductivity, good transport number, leak-proof, aqueous and non-aqueous properties. The films using these are flexible and therefore better interfacial contacts are ensured. Such polymer gel electrolytes can be utilized in batteries, supercapacitor, fuel cells, sensors, electrochromic devices, and the solar cells. The emphasis of our research group is on battery applications. Once we fabricate the electrolytes, then we need to investigate whether they are suitable or not, or what are their properties. For the structural and morphological characterization, we go for XRT, FTIR, and SEM. And for the electrochemical characterization, we look for AC impedance spectroscopy, transport number measurement, and the cyclic voltammetry. Our group is working on last 12 years on the magnesium and sodium based electrolytes and their batteries. The main motivation of using such kind of electrolytes is their low cost and high natural abundance. Apart from that, they are having electrochemical potential quite close to that of the rival lithium. Now, how a typical polymer gel electrolyte can be prepared? So I have taken a specific example of polymethacrylate based system in which sodium salt solution has been taken. We mixed and sterilized them thoroughly, and ultimately we get a flexible polymer gel electrolyte. To know their ionic conductivity, we do the Nequesent plots, and from the plots we measure the bulk resistance, which is the x-axis intercept on the z-axis, z prime axis, which gives you bulk resistance, followed by the ionic conductivity calculated from the simple formula. The composition with highest ionic conductivity has been taken for further analysis, like electrochemical stability window. We have measured the electrochemical stability window of the electrolyte to be 3.3 volt, which is good enough to realize the electrochemical system. In order to know the ion conduction behavior, the dielectric studies are performed. We can see at the low frequency region, we can see there is accumulation of charges and thereby the dielectric constant is also high. At the other end, the high frequency end, we can see the dielectric constant values are relatively low. The reason being the dipoles are unable to orient at such high frequencies. Using the optimized electrolyte, we have fabricated prototype sodium battery also. The open circuit voltage is greater than 2 volt and discharge capacity is more than 550 milliampere hour per gram. And this kind of battery system which we have fabricated for a prototype can be utilized for further applications after like doing more work on the cathode side. This performance can even be enhanced at a newer level. So we conclude the flexible electrolytes are preferred because of their specific features. The physical and electrochemical characterization help us in establishing their suitability for a particular application. Experimental studies confirm us that these can be utilized for application as a sodium metal sulfur batteries or other sodium ion battery applications. We think at a later stage also that non-flammable kind of electrolytes can be developed and sodium ion batteries can be fabricated. We already published some work on metal sulfur batteries, and these are some recent publications of our group. Thank you very much.